you get a weight trainer. Sorry, not weight trainer. Hello. Now, all these, if I'm telling names, you will not, honestly not understand, if, especially if you have no idea what these workouts are. Hi, you guys. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, I'm Akanksha. So in this video, you read the title already. We're going to talk about my workouts, what I'm doing, especially in the 75-day challenge that I'm doing. Now, before going ahead and talking about anything related to workout, I just want to give like a big disclaimer that I'm nowhere a professional about it. This is it. Now, in the videos I'm going to show you, I don't have a trainer as well, but I have gone to gym for a while now before the break that I took for a year, so I know how to do majority of the exercises. So I just started by myself and I just go to the gym and do whatever works for me. So nowhere in this is for you to take inspiration. My form could be wrong according to some people, and these exercises might not work for some people, but this is just my personal fitness routine, and in no way I'm in no capacity to give you advice on what to do, but since you guys wanted to see how I'm planning out my 75 day and what all workouts I do, I just thought I will, you know, let you guys know. So yeah, let's get started. Okay, so let's start off with my basic gym workouts. Now, if not for 75 days, ideally a 5-workout week is great for gym. You need to rest your body for at least 1 to 2 days for your muscles to recover and relax your bodies. If not, it kind of can be very draining, especially if you intensely do weightlifting. But because I'm doing 75 day, I have to do 2 workouts in a day. So I kind of do different workouts throughout the week to kind of keep me going, because hitting gym and lifting weights every day might not be the healthiest, according to my opinion and what I've heard from people. You need to give your muscles that time to relax or recover, like I said. So let's start off with a basic first one, which I do. Now, there are different body parts you aim at in a gym. Now, if you have been to a gym, you know how it goes. First things first, if you're a complete beginner, I would ask you to just start off with basic cardio, like just go for a walk for 20 minutes a day, or hit the treadmill, do cycling, and you can do basic stretches. Now, there are hundreds of different videos on YouTube which might help you to do just a beginner workout, where they're like squats, there is you know, just stretching and everything, which can be very overwhelming for first day as well. Even on the first day when I was starting my 75 day after like a year long break, for me to just do like hands rotation for like 10-15 times only was a lot, because you get so tired and because your body is not used to that physical exercise. Now, one thing I want you guys to keep in mind for sure is that don't excessively strain yourself and, you know, do all the workouts ki 1 month mein only I want to lose all my weight. That's extremely unhealthy in a way, because you are so exhausted all the time, and especially when you're so exhausted, you tend to overeat, which is something you don't want, especially if you're trying to get into a healthier lifestyle. Try doing very, very light workouts if your body, you know, just has to get used to it. That's what I did. Since the start of the first 2-3 days of my workouts, I just did like some normal YouTube videos, just light cardio workout, just to get your body used to it. Even in that, you will get body pains, so make it a very stress-free workout so that it's sustainable and you can go on for your entire life. Workouts are not something which you do for a short period of time, right? So that being said, give yourself at least 3 to 4 days to just get used to going to a gym or just used to exercising, and then after that you can start with weight training. Now, for first day of weightlifting, or for my weekly routine, what I do is there's a push day, there's a pull day. So for a push day, it's basically chest day and triceps day. Now, for chest, I do different exercises like bench press, I do elevated bench press, I do push-ups, then I do different, like, you know, again, chest exercises, which you can always Google and see. Now, if you're first, like, beginner to weight training, I would definitely suggest you get a weight trainer, sorry, not weight trainer, a trainer, if you can afford it, because that will help you a lot in getting your form right. A lot of minute things can be wrong, and that might affect your, you know, body getting toned and your muscle hitting different muscle as well. So if you can afford it, you know, definitely get a trainer, at least just for like the first month, where you can, you know, what basic exercises are, so that next month, say, you can do by yourself. Hello. I hate being interrupted while filming, but adulting pro max. But anyways, I was saying what? Kushi hai. Hey, hi, Kushi. So anyways, let's get to my first day, which is Monday. Let's say I do like a chest day, so chest and triceps, which is a push day. So for chest, I do like a flat bench press, then I do incline bench press. You can do flies, you can do extensions. If you have like a proper equipped gym, then you have a lot more machines like cable extensions and different exercises. Again, if you go to any gym, you will generally have a normal floor trainer who will help you with basics anyways, so that will also help you learn these exercises better. Then for triceps, I do a bench, like I sit on the bench and then extend my legs. I don't know how to explain this, but yeah, you put your hands on the bench and you go down, and then you have tricep extensions, then cable, same extensions. But then the second day, basically generally I do, is a pull day, which has back and biceps, which I actually did today and I'm very, very sore. So for back, again, you have the machine where you do the back extension. I don't know the names of these workouts. Few things I know, few I don't. But yeah, it's called lat pull, if I'm not wrong. With the machine, you can do that. And then you can do dumbbell rowing. You can do, again, the cable pull. So these are all the videos you can see. I have filmed whatever I do. These are very, like, these are all basic workouts only, whatever I film. Because I also started after a break. I'm also only doing the beginner stuff with very like minimal weight, so anybody honestly can do this. There's nothing pro level about these exercises. For bicep, you can do bicep curl, then you can do a hammer curl, and you can do with a rod also if you want. So again, at least I make sure I'm hitting 3 to 4 exercises per body part. So let's say back, I do 3 exercises, then bicep I do 3. If I have time, then I do 4 and 4, or sometimes if I want to do more biceps, then I'll do 3 back and 4 biceps, and that really depends on you. But 3 for sure, like 3 exercises per body part is like a mandate. And I do 15 reps. So the first set I do with like the minimum weight, then with every set I increase my weight, and if the repetitions get too much, then the third set I generally do somewhere between 12 to 15. But yeah, 15 is something I, you know, generally go for. Then after back day, we have shoulder and abs. Shoulder exercises are pretty common. Shoulder press, shoulder shrugs, I do side lateral raises, front raises. These are everything which target your shoulder. And then for abs, honestly, I don't have any fixed workouts that I do. I kind of take any video online and get inspired and do the exercises. A few things which I like to do for abs is Russian twists, then they're called dead bugs. Now all these, if I'm telling names, you will not, honestly not understand, if, especially if you have no idea what these workouts are. But you can check online for apps, though. You have so many videos. Honestly, you can really just go for any 20 minute ab workout and you can do it. You have leg raises, you have full crunch, half crunch, plank twist. You have so many different workouts for abs, and everything targets your core, planks, everything. So abs, so that is generalized, there's nothing fixed. Now fourth day, this day is leg day, a day that most people dread, but lately I've been enjoying leg day so much, especially for women. Leg day is so much fun, I feel, because we have the most strength in our lower body while men have the most strength in their upper body. So like maybe if I do 5 kgs for my hand and a man can do like 20 kg biceps, I can do like opposite for legs and he can do like 5 kg for legs, if that makes sense. So starting off with legs, I start off with my warm-up, leg day thorough warm-up. And for warm-up, I do squats. I do around 50 squats. You can do 10, 20, 20, or you can do 15, 15, 20. Depends on whatever you want. I do without any weight, normal squats, just to warm up my legs. After this, you can go in for weighted squats if you want. Then you can do sumo squats. Now this, in the video that day, I wanted to do lunges, so I did lunges. Oh my God, it killed me that day. Then I did glute bridges. Then I did leg extension, if you have that machine in your gym, and that's a basic exercise. extension to have. So you can do leg extension, then you can lie down and do hamstring curl with the same leg extension machine. Then you can do calf lift. They will get the job done. Glute bridges, of course, for us, if you want that nice ass, then glute bridges, of course, will give you that proper burn for you to get that good amount of muscle in that place. Now, one more thing about weightlifting, if you lift weights and if you're trying to lose weight also, it can be a little tricky, especially if you're somebody who's dead focused on the scale. Now, I'm 50 days into 75-day workout and I've been doing two workouts every single day. But the day I started, I was 66 kgs and today I'm 68 kgs. So I in fact put on 2 kgs, but you should know that when you're lifting weights, you will gain muscle as well. And I've been very good with my diet. I've been having a lot of protein, so I've been good to build my muscle. So although I am losing fat, I am building muscle as well. So the scale is lying to me because my clothes are fitting me better. I lost a lot of inches on my hip area because that's where I gained a lot of weight. My pants are fitting me better. Everything overall, I've lost a lot of inches, but on the scale, it is more like extra 2 kgs. So don't be very dead focused on the scale. You just have your food and your calorie deficit. So I have around 1600 calories, 1500 calories a day. So you can just eat under the calorie mark and then just do your workouts and just don't focus much on your scale because it can lie to you. The muscle of one thing can be this much while fat can be this much. So after leg day, you have 1 day which I do HIIT. Now after all these workouts, if you're not doing 75 day, I would recommend you to do at least 10 to 15 minutes of cardio, like a normal walk or cycling or that rowing, whatever, just so that if you want to lose fat, then that's the best thing to do because you'll burn a lot more fat after lifting weights. I am doing a second workout in the night as well, which generally is a walk. I generally go for like a 45-50 minutes walk every day outdoors because I have to do something outdoors. So I don't do any cardio in the morning. But if you do only one workout, then after lifting weights, then go ahead and do like a 20-minute cardio workout. It'll be really nice. Walking is the best, honestly, way to burn fat. It's just like if you eat right and then you walk, it burns so many calories. So remember that if you do like a full day workout and just sit like a slump the entire day, honestly, you would not see much of a difference. So put like a steps target. I'm hitting 8k steps most of my days because I am walking. So put a like a steps target so that you burn fat in the form of walking, and it's the easiest way, honestly, to lose fat. So even if you're not doing any weightlifting, anything, just walk, you guys, half an hour in a day, or put like a steps limit or something. Just walk so that your body, you know, goes into that fat burning mode while you are having a good diet in your everyday life. So then HIIT again really depends. Now I hate burpees, but I still do them because they burn like so much. So I do high knees, I do jumping jacks, I do burpees, then I do abs also the same day if I want. Then I do what is it called, kettlebell swing, it's called that exercise, and so many different HIIT. Honestly, again, there are so many videos for HIIT. You can do squats, you can do jumping squats, everything. This is like high intense workouts. There's a lot of jumping, there's a lot of breathlessness involved, that hence, you know, you see burpees, I see breathlessness. So literally it is that. You can do shoulder taps, planks, any different. I kind of keep it different every week so that I am not bored. And yeah, these are my 5 days of workout in the gym. Okay, so I make sure I do this. And for 2 other days, what I do is, I'm recently I started going to badminton, especially after I started 75 day, because again, as like I told, I don't want to hit the gym every day. And badminton, I love it. I don't know why I stopped playing badminton. I used to play in school a lot and then I just stopped it for some reason, and it burns so many calories and I love it. Sport is so much, such a fun way to work out, honestly. And badminton is like though the best way because there's so much running you need to do, there's so much bending. Like I love badminton. So I've been doing badminton at least 2-3 times a week, and then I go for swimming sometimes. If I'm no mood to go for walk, then I go for swimming. training because I have to do an outdoor workout. Actually, I really love the 75-day challenge because it's pushing me to do things which I generally don't do, and I want to, like, you know, because I have to right now, I'm thinking about different ways to do. So I go for swimming sometimes. Then I recently went to aerial yoga as well, which is again super fun to do. So I'm trying to incorporate different workouts in my routine. But yes, oh my god, I should not forget to tell this. So after this 5 days of gym, one day for sure, one workout, let's say, like, it's not mandated that I have to do badminton both the two of the other days. What I sometimes do is I do yoga as well. Now yoga is something I'm trying to make sure I at least do once a week, because honestly there's no point of gaining muscle and, you know, strength if your body is not flexible. So I try to do mobility and yoga at least once a week. If not, I try to do once, but it's best if you do twice, because honestly having a flexible body is the best, like, compared to anything, you know, else, because you want to able to sit, get up without any pain. So just doing gym does not make sense. So even after your workout, if you sometimes just want to stretch properly for 15-20 minutes, do some light yoga or light stretches, that's like a best thing. And I would highly recommend you to concentrate on mobility and strength training together, because just one would not benefit you much in any way. So these are the things I am trying to do. I really want to start going cycling. I have more 20 days 20-25 days left for my thing, and I don't have a cycle, or else I would have done cycling for my outdoor, but I at this point I don't want to invest. But I found something near my house recently where I can rent one, so I'm thinking I'll go for cycling. So these are the different things you have, guys, as options for outdoor workouts. You can go running, jogging, hiking, what else? These are the few things that I have in my mind at the moment. But yeah, the indoor mostly is gym, outdoor are these different things. And tennis, you can play cricket, you can play football, you can play basketball, any sport, like, honestly, is an outdoor workout, which is, again, sport is such a fun way to burn calories. So yeah, those are all the different workouts that I have been doing in 75 days. One of you guys requested this video, so I thought I will let you guys know what I'm doing. If you want me to do any more videos related to, like, 75 day, let me know. I would love to do it for you guys, but for this video, this is about it, and I hope really it is useful. Again, before going, I'm not a professional in this, I'm not trained in this, I have no degree in this. This is just what works for me and what I've been doing for myself. And I've lost, I don't want to say I lost weight, because on the scale I have not, but I lost a lot of inches, and I'm feeling much better about myself. But honestly, my 75 days to just get consistent with working out. I had no goal of, like, losing this fixed amount of weight, because I did not want to be fixated on the scale, like I told you, because if I was, the minute I saw the scale go 2 kgs above than the weight I started, I would have been demotivated. So I'm not looking at the scale at the moment, just trying to be consistent and work out. And I hope this inspires you to, you know, get into working out as well. And yeah, that's about it for this video. Let me know what more you want to see, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.